Hey there, I'm Darren. I'm walking the West Highland Way from Mulgay, just outside of Glasgow, to Fort William in the Scottish Highlands. 96 miles over the last week of March in 5 days. Stopping overnight in a campsite, a bothy, wild camping and a bunkhouse. Living from my bergen and what I can get along the way. So grab a drink, sit back, and hopefully you'll enjoy it as much as I did. So today I want to go from Drymen camping to Lochy, which is a pre-booked campsite, wild camping site, because you need a permit to go to stop wild camping along the loch. Or plan B, we're going to go to Rowchoish Bothy. So we're going to set off from Drymen camping, follow the road along, all the way up till we get into the wood line, cut through the wood line, and then we're going to go either over Connachill into Palmerhaugh, or we're going to go round the hill and into Palmerhaugh. Once we're in Palmerhaugh, then we're going to follow the shore side of the loch and up, all the way up into Sulocky. This is Sulocky here. Okay, Sulocky, like I said, it's a pre wild camping site, so you need to go and book a pitch. It costs you £4 online, as you can see in there. Okay, because it's got a permit holders, and if you get caught, then you get a fine. So we're going to go into there. Okay, that's plan A. Or plan B is we're going to carry on up this track. Again, handrail in the shore of the loch, Loch Lomond. Get to the fork in the track. Follow the lower track along, all the way along, and into Rowchoish Bothy. So, what we're going now to, up to Connachill. Now, I'm not sure if, because when I was looking on the website, there might be some works happening on Connachill to repair the footpath and that before the season starts at the beginning of April. So hopefully it's opened up. If not, we're going to have to do a little detour around the Connachill into Palmerhaugh. But hopefully we can get to the top of the hill. Apparently, glorious views of Loch Lomond from up there, which will be good. So we'll just have to see what happens when we get there. Unfortunately, Connachill is closed to get repair work to the footpath before the actual main season starts. You better run, run, run if you wanna be free.
There you see Connick Hill in all its splendour. It's quite a tricky little hill by the looks of it. Coffee, just a quick pit stop. Had me bacon roll and a cup of coffee. It's not as far away as it seems. Probably about the size of Michelle. That's my wife. Brilliant. Love it. Definitely why we climb up hills. We got absolutely spectacular views. Oh yeah, beautiful. Just to see if it's possible. Don't care what I've been told. I want to run to the end of the world. Tom was born in 1942. That's the case. And the doctor said I'm railing Loch Lomond now. For the next 10 or so miles at least. Massive lock. As he took his first breath, his mother took her last.
And his father knew that he wasn't to blame, but he never quite looked at Tom the same after that.
So the plan is tab on another 8 mile. There's a bothy called, I believe, Rowchoish. Rowchoish Bothy. So hopefully should hit there. Hit there about 5:30, 6 o'clock. To get myself in there for the night. It's pointless getting myself there, get the tent out. And getting it soaking on night two. So that's the plan anyway. Could be changing, that's what I'm working on the moment. Might stop somewhere in a little town or a little pub or something for a little quick bite to eat before a crack on. They moved with each other. And that's the plan. When the music got slower, he said, don't let go of my hand.
He said, it's only polite if I ask you tonight, would it be all right if I could walk you home?
This is the accommodation for tonight. Rowchoish Bothy. It's quite nice.
Well, 2 quick years they went by, they were side by side. And without a